You know, people tell me, hey, you make some funny productivity content. It's kind of ironic, but there's nothing funny about email. So I'm gonna try to make this as entertaining as possible because I hate email. But there are a couple of things that make me hate it a little There are a couple of things that make me hate it a little less. And that mainly comes from me looking cool and me saving time. So first of all, what sucks is when I open up my email and I get an email from someone. Like, for example, let's say my assistant wants to make a time with me. And for some reason they looked at my calendar and they didn't just say, hey, let's meet then. They're like, when can we meet, Dimitri? And I say, assistant, one, thank you for working for me. I'm appreciative. But two, I'm just gonna make a time with you like this. If I go here and press compose and then go to my templates in Gmail, I can then press set up a meeting with me. Hey, look at that. What's this? Hey there, I'm following up with you on when I can meet up for a call. Look at this. And then what does this link go to? Ah, my tidy cal, so that somebody can just make a time with me. I don't really enjoy when people ask me, hey, when can you meet? And then there's email correspondence. There's two levels of templates in here. One, there's a calendar that says when I'm available. And two, I just send them an email that's pretty standard and looks like I actually wrote it, but I didn't write it. If I send that to you, I wrote it once. Honestly, I also have one for if a sponsor were to, not be good enough. So what I do is I actually go here and go to templates and do polite sponsorship denial. And I quite literally have fields here. So it's like, hello, and then I change the name to the name. And I really appreciate you and the company name reaching out to me, but no. And the best part about this is that I don't have to rewrite an apology every time. And it makes it look like I'm being more polite to sponsors. Because a lot of the times I don't want to say yes, but I don't want to say no. But since I've only really written no once, I can just do it over and over again. But a sponsorship I didn't say no to was wisestamp. And you'll notice in this email here, I got a fancy looking signature there. And the reason for that is because of wisestamp. Just like with the templates and how that increased your productivity personally and your business productivity, wisestamp can increase your productivity via the way that it makes you have more authority just from how dang good that looks. And to clarify, you will increase your response rate when you have an email signature that looks as nice as this. In here on wisestamp, I can not only just put my name, my title, and company, but I can link things like my website, I can put my phone number, my email, or even my address. And I like the touch that you can actually add a picture there as well. If you work on a team, this is vital to making sure that your branding is on point. You're gonna have people across your team have something that looks similar so that you have the same look and feel represented across all of your email signatures at your company. And within wisestamp, you can actually apply a banner across everyone in your company with just a few clicks. What I really enjoy is the fact that you have templates to choose from when you start out here so that you don't have any questions regarding how should this thing look. It gives you great ideas right off the bat. And then you can also add different call to actions or have an ending to your email like best regards, rather than having to write it down every single time. Like for example, with what I showed earlier with the book a meeting, I could actually just set this up with my provider that I already had. So this is my tidycal link, and I can change the different type of call to action that's there. I can make it full, light, or just simple link, and change the branding as well. So I'm gonna go here, make it a small one, tweak the color a little bit, and then press add. And then this is in my email signature. You can even enhance it with something like a styled sign off or quotes. So I'm gonna go here to styled signature, and I can put something like kind regards, and it looks like I actually wrote it. Or I can make it plain or even have it animated. I'm gonna choose a small kind regards, press add. Then when I'm done editing, I can publish changes. And if I refresh my Gmail and go here, you'll see that this is exactly how I had it set up in wisestamp. It's very easy to add wisestamp. All you gotta do is add it to your Chrome extension and then enable it with the right app, and it'll pop up just like this. As you can see, you can add it to Gmail, Mac, Outlook for desktop, Outlook for web, your iPhone even, and a bunch of other ones. As you can also just take the HTML email signature, because it is just HTML that they're putting at the bottom and making it look nice. Thanks again to wisestamp for sponsoring this video. Also, make sure to use my link and code down below to get you 35% off your pro subscription for your first year. I may like how my email signature looks now, but what I really like is if you checked out wisestamp's website at wisestamp.com, and if you checked out this video on how to improve your productivity even more.